Think of the best day of your life. A wedding day, a graduation, something like that. It's probably pretty easy to recall what day it happened and who was there, right? Well, now imagine you remember what you had for breakfast the day before, and whether your favorite sports team won the next day, and whether it rained on July 20th the previous year. Sounds like a superpower, but the real-life people who remember everything that happens to them would call it more of a mixed blessing. Still, studying these super-rememberers could help us understand why I don't even know what I had for lunch 2 days ago, and more. Highly superior autobiographical memory, or HSAM, is a condition where people have an extraordinary ability to remember personal past events. It's very rare. Fewer than 100 people are known to have this memory difference globally, though there are probably cases that go unreported. These people can recall dates and times of events in their life and what happened during those events with astonishing detail and accuracy. People with HSAM have been able to tell researchers the dates and times of seemingly uneventful days picked at random from their past, as well as seemingly mundane details about that day, such as what they ate or who they met. Like, ah, yes, October 14th, 2004, my friends and I hung out at Claire's. It was 2004, it's a pretty safe bet we were at Claire's. This is different than having a so-called photographic memory, where people can memorize lots of specific details. The A in HSAM stands for autobiographical, which means it only applies to things that relate to that person's specific experiences in life. So people with HSAM are no better than anyone else at, say, cramming for exams, even though they may remember lots of facts about their own past. So what is it that allows the brains of people with HSAM to store and retrieve these memories so well? And could we learn from them how to improve our own ability to remember? To understand why people with HSAM have such good recall, it's helpful to look at how we actually make memories. Memories are complex things. A single memory is made up of a network of neurons connected by synapses. Synapses are little gaps between the neurons. Signaling molecules called neurotransmitters can jump the gap to carry information across. Imagine a memory, then, like a series of roads connected by bridges. The more times the bridges are used, the stronger the connections and network become. But the less the bridges are used, the weaker they become, and eventually they can crumble away and the memory fades. Something we wouldn't bother recalling, like what we had for dinner on a normal, boring Saturday, will probably disappear quickly. You're not maintaining the bridges, so they fall apart. But not so for people with HSAM. What keeps their bridges intact?
This SciShow video is supported by Jump, a statistical analysis software that makes powerful analytics quick and accessible. Like, imagine running 5 experiments at once with the same time and effort that it usually takes to run just one. Jump gives you the analytical power to basically make that happen. Jump's prediction profiler tool disentangles the contributions of different variables in your dataset to move science more quickly with fewer inputs and more insights. They even have screening designs to cope with noisy data and identify the most informative data points in the bunch. Let's be real. If you can't figure out what your data means, collecting it can feel futile. Jump is founded on the principle that every statistic can be visualized, and that's how we figure out what data means. So they do everything they can to help you comb through your data so none of it goes to waste. And Jump offers a 30-day free trial for anyone, anywhere. So to see the benefits of visual statistics for yourself, you can go to jmp.com/scishow.
HSAM might be linked to differences in brain structure and function. Neuroimaging has shown that people with HSAM have slightly larger and more active regions associated with memory processing. They also exhibit increased connectivity between these brain areas, although this could be a result of their constant and highly detailed remembering rather than a cause. But interestingly, people with HSAM perform about the same as anybody else in standard memory tests that involve information that isn't personal history, stuff like memorizing random lists of words or numbers, or recalling stories others have told them. So the clue to their superior memory might be in personalization. Some theories suggest that emotional experiences play a significant role in memory retention, since we recall emotionally charged events way more vividly. And one study found people with HSAM were more likely to imagine and daydream, and had a tendency toward absorption, that is, paying close attention to any activity they are engaged in. People with HSAM also often report experiencing compulsive compulsive memory retrieval, meaning they revisit past experiences without actively trying to. That may further strengthen the memory networks in their brains. So the idea is this: people with HSAM have a greater and more emotional experience of even mundane activities, and that creates a rich initial memory. Then they revisit those memories repeatedly, embedding memory networks strongly over time. And like I hinted before, HSAM isn't exactly the fun superpower it might seem to be. Imagine recalling every embarrassing, sad, or rage-inducing moment you ever experienced. People with HSAM have reported feeling overwhelmed by their constant and sometimes intrusive memories. Like, my brain already brings up the time that I called my teacher mom in fourth grade often enough. Imagine that happening constantly and vividly. Now, it can be difficult to make general assumptions about memory from studying such a small group of people. Still, scientists are hopeful that learning more about this unique group could help us understand cognitive decline in people with memory disorders like Alzheimer's disease. Comparing active brain regions of people with HSAM and people with Alzheimer's could help us understand how the disease progressively deletes memory and which parts of the brain might be especially vulnerable to autobiographical memory loss. So, while we might not need science to tell us that our most special moments in life stay with us forever, these super rememberers can give us a fascinating insight into why and how that actually happens.